All right, let's do some practice questions. So x squared and times 6. So that would be 6x squared. Now what? Two numbers multiply to give you 6, adding to give you 5. Can you think of those? 3 times 2. So 3x plus 2x, add up to give you 5x, multiply to give you 6x squared, right? So 3x plus 2x is 5x, but their multiplication is the 6x squared that we require. So we're going to rewrite that then as x squared plus 3x plus 2x plus 6. So now you're going to do factor by grouping. First two terms plus last two terms. So you can pull out an x from those two, get x plus 3. Here's a trick you can think of. Once you do the first two terms, you know that this second term has to have x plus 3 in it. So you can put the x plus 3 here and then adjust the outside so that when you distribute this number or term that's here across this addition by using the distributive property, you should get this term here. So you know I need a 2 because only plus 2 times x will give me a plus 2x. So that's one way to make sure you really got it right. And if you try to do that and it's not working, then you know you have a mistake somewhere here in the split. Okay, so the next step would be that, which you know how to do now. So x plus 2, x plus 3 are the factors of that. One thing you might want to think about is this. If the leading coefficient is 1, that means the number that sits in front of x squared, then eventually you'll start to notice a pattern that, okay, 1 times 6 is 6, and 2 plus 3 is 5, and so then x plus 2, x plus 3. So these two numbers multiply to give you 6, add to give you 5. So you start noticing that pattern. But until you do that, make sure you go through all the steps of factor by grouping to factor. And remember, this pattern only works that I just told you about if the coefficient is 1. So if the coefficient is not 1, you have to do this. Otherwise, you're going to be stuck. Some of you might be proficient in factor by trial and error method, in which case, that's fine. But if you are stuck, just use this method. So do really practice and be proficient in this method. That's the method that we really want you to learn. And what's the name of that method? Just factor by grouping. All right, so 6x squared, and it will be negative because you have a negative 6. So two numbers multiplying to give you negative 6, add to give you negative 1x. So negative 3 and positive 2 will take care of that. So let's rewrite it. Okay, now what? Yes, factor by grouping, good. First two terms, last two terms. And then rewrite it so that you have pulled out the x minus 3 and you have x plus 2 left. Any questions here, just rewind, go back, make sure you can understand every single step. The split, once you get that split, then you're really home free if you have not made any mistakes here. Again, remember the trick I told you. Pull out the greatest common factor of the first two terms, and then this factor here is going to be this factor here, and then adjust the sign on the outside and the number on the outside, so that when you multiply, distribute throughout this number over this addition or subtraction that you have, you should get these last two terms here. So an observation, make sure you're always checking your answers by multiplying it out. So once you have your factors, you can use distributive property and multiply out. For example, x times x is x squared, x times negative 3 is negative 3x, plus 2 times x is positive 2x, negative 3x plus 2x is going to give you negative 1x, and positive 2 times negative 3 is going to give you negative 6. So you can do a for my eyes only column and multiply it out to make sure you really got it. You may want to do that in the beginning while you're just learning to factor. All right, let's do some more practice questions, which means you're going to have to pause the video for every question. So let's start with that. Go ahead, try that on your own. Pause the video, please. Remember the steps. Let's just quick review the steps. Factor out greatest common factor out first. Then whatever remaining trinomial you're left with, use the method you just learned, factor by grouping, and then complete the factoring. All right, let's take a look at this one here. Assuming you've paused and come back, all of these terms share something. What do they share? They share a T. All right, so let's factor out the T. So now you have x squared plus 5x plus 6. Oh, I would recommend strongly making a formalized only column here so that the work here is clean and tidy. So this x squared plus 5x plus 6, let's put that here and factor it out. So 6x squared is the multiplication. And then once you have that, we want to factor it into two numbers, multiplying to give you 6x squared, adding to give you 5x. So 3x and 2x like we saw before. And so now we're going to rewrite this polynomial. And then what? Between those two terms, you can pull out an x. So you're going to have x plus 3 left. You want x plus 3 here, so 2 here, because plus 2 times x is 2x, plus 2 times plus 3 is plus 6. So then you adjust that term out here. So your factors are x plus 2 times x plus 3 for x squared plus 5x plus 6. So you're going to go here and rewrite it then. This t, remember, is going to carry through because it's already there. You can't just drop a factor out. So t times x plus 2 times x plus 3 is the factors of that first one. All right, let's do the second one on your own. Pause the video here, see what you can do. Again, remember, first step is always to pull out the greatest common factor. Are you pausing? You see, try it on your own, because if you get wrong now, then when we do it correctly, you'll see where you made mistakes, so you can actually learn from it. All right, so do they share anything in common? What do you think they all share? They share a B. Is there anything else they share? One way to check whether they share something is to factor everything. So factor all of these numbers so you can see. Well, they have a 2 in them. All of them have at least a 2 squared in it, so 4, right? So factor out the 4, basically. So they have a 2, and the powers are 3, 2, and 2. So clearly the power of 2 is going to be the greatest common factor. So 2 squared, or 4, is the greatest common factor. And then also, what? A B, good. All right, so 2 squared, so 4B is the greatest common factor. Write down what's left. You're left with 2 times 3, because we pulled out 2 squared, and this was 2 cubed. So there is a 2 left from here, a 3, and an a squared. A 2 squared is already pulled out. We need a 7 and a and a b, because a b squared is present here. And here 2 squared is sitting out, and 5 and b squared, because we only pulled out 1 b. So that's why, what are we have left here now? 4b times 6s squared minus 7ab minus 5b squared. So this is a trinomial now that we're going to put to the side here and use our factor by grouping method. So take a look. 6 times negative 5. So negative 30a squared b squared. Two numbers multiplying to give you negative 30 and adding to give you negative 7. So 10 times 3. Negative 10ab plus 3ab. Those two together add up to negative 7ab. And those two multiply to give you negative 30a squared b squared. So let's rewrite it. All right. Now what? 6 and 10, so you can pull out a 2, and we can pull out an a. So from the first two terms, 2a times 3a is 6a squared. 2a times negative 5b is the negative 10. And then 3ab minus 5b squared. If I wrote the 3a minus 5b, I need a b out here so that when I multiply out, I get these two terms. So my factors are going to be 2a plus b times 3a minus 5b. All right, so let's go back here and put them here. So we have 4b, which is from here, from before. And then this factors are from here, which is 2a plus b, 3a minus 5b. That's it. That's all there is to factoring. So it's really not that difficult. You just have to make sure you practice enough and start seeing, you know, numbers. The trick, or the harder part where people might get stuck, is right here. Two numbers multiplying to give you that number, adding to give you that number. And when you do enough of it, you'll just start to see it in your head. Okay? Does it matter whether I write 4b times 2a plus b times 3a minus 5b, or 4b times 3a minus 5b times 2a plus b? What do you think? No, it doesn't matter because multiplication is commutative. Remember, things like that, the y part you need to know. All right, let's try a few more examples then. Go try that on your own. Pause the video and continue. Assuming you've paused and come back. So we can pull out what? A 2 it looks like across all these. So a 2 is factored out, and then this is what's left, which is 12x squared plus 11x minus 5. So let's go for my's only. 2, 12 times negative 5, negative 60x squared. So we need two numbers giving you addition to be 11 and multiplying together to give you negative 60. If the addition is positive and this is a negative number, we know one is positive, one is negative, and you need the larger number to be positive, so you get positive 11. So 15 and negative 4. And then rewrite it. These two terms, you can pull out an x and a 3. So you're going to have 3x times 4x plus 5, because 3x times 4x is 12x squared. 3x times positive 5 is 15x. So I'm going to write the 4x plus 5 here and then decide what to put out here. You can see what times 4x is giving me negative 4x. The only thing that will do is negative 1. So that's why the negative 1 is out here. So 4x plus 5 is the greatest common factor. And so we're going to have 4x plus 5 times the leftover from here is 3x. Leftover here is negative 1. So those are our final factors here then. This 2, remember, this 2 will just carry through. You can't just leave a factor out. So 2 times 4x plus 5 times 3x minus 1. All right, let's try this. X is the greatest common factor. And now you have this. A question to you is, just think about it before we do this. Do you think that this process will always give you factors or not? Well, let's see. All right, 8x squared times 1 is going to give you what? Good. Two numbers multiplying to give you 8, adding to give you 20. Do you think that's possible? Well, all the numbers multiplying to give you 8 are what? 1 and 8, which will give you addition to be 9. 4 and 2, which will give you 6. And that's it, isn't it? So the largest addition we can get for numbers that multiply to give you 8 is going to be 9. So 20 is not possible. So when that happens, you are going to say what? Well, can't really have this happening, and so this is an irreducible polynomial, which means it does not factor anymore. So that's your answer. That's your final answer right there.